fair elections, the cornerstone of American democracy. Psych. Let me tell you why that's a load of malarkey. We've been told over and over again that every vote counts. Like when those cool celebrities tell you to go out and rock the vote. But when it comes to electing your representatives, you know, those people that write the laws, there are cases when your vote doesn't really count. And that's no accident. Politicians do it on purpose. It's called gerrymandering, the age-old art of rigging the system. Politicians use population and voting data to create new voting districts so that their party has a better chance of winning the most districts overall. Like in this case, where blue wins 3 out of 5 districts, even though there are fewer blue voters than red voters. Both Democrats and Republicans gerrymander. It's probably the reason why in the 2016 elections, Democrats won 47% of the vote for North Carolina's House seats, but only ended up with 23% of the seats. This isn't just a North Carolina problem. It happens all over the map. And people are starting to get mad.
Gerrymandering has created an absurd reality.
Gerrymandering is vote rigging.
That is voter fraud.
That is real voter fraud.
So what is gerrymandering? And what can we do to stop it? Well, gerrymandering is all kinds of complicated, but it boils down to some of my favorite things: data, geography, and geometry. Every state is split into districts. You've got congressional districts, where each district gets 1 rep in the U.S. House of Representatives. Every 10 years, states redraw the district lines to account for people moving and other population changes. There are 2 big rules that govern how we draw district lines. Number 1, districts have to have the same number of people. And number 2, thanks to the Voting Rights Act, districts can't be racist, which means you can't clump all the people of color into one district or spread them out so much that their vote doesn't mean anything. Just to be clear here, racial gerrymandering is not allowed, but political gerrymandering, that's okay. Mathematically, there are like a gazillion ways that you could split a state into districts. Each state has its own process for drawing these lines, and most are done by lawmakers, aka the politicians in power. With the help of computer programs, politicians use population and voter data to make predictions about how different geographical arrangements will likely vote. If they want to guarantee their party stays in power, they can just divide up the districts to squeeze out the other party, pretty much just negating the opposition's votes. It's the reason you get districts that look like a praying mantis or an upside down elephant. When this happens, you can end up with districts that are mostly made up of one party. So it's really hard to vote elected officials out of office. The opposing party just can't win. Time for a demonstration. Jerry, bring out the whiteboard. So Jerry's brought out my handy little whiteboard here. But first, let me get my teaching glasses and hat ready for you guys. All right. So, class, what we have here is a city district. These squares represent, we'll say, Republicans, and these circles represent the Democrats. Now, the Democrats want to crack the Republican vote. They would just do it like this. Okay, so you have this little line right here, little line right there, little line like that. And see, what we have here is they've diluted the Republican vote and absorbed it into the Democratic vote, so the Democrats would win each of those districts. That's called cracking. And you also have something that's called packing. Now, packing varies from cracking because, well, cracking, what you do, what we did was we broke it down. Packing, we're gonna clump it in. Maybe do a little something like that, then come back up, and then voila, right? So what we've done is we've sacrificed this one district all for the sake of these other districts. You see what I'm saying? Now you have a greater chance of getting districts all around the one in the middle. So this is what politicians are doing to dilute votes from various communities around the country. And there you have it, cracking and packing. You just learned something. So what can we do to confront this affront to democracy? Well, here's a couple of ideas. One is take the humans out of the process entirely and leave it up to computers. We can write computer algorithms that ignore political data and draw district lines based on population size and neat and tidy shapes. None of this praying mantis nonsense. But not everyone's sold on this idea. How can we make sure that these districts are actually more fair, or that they don't violate the Voting Rights Act? Another solution is to take redistricting out of the hands of the politicians and give the power to the people. A few states, like California, have independent commissions in charge of redistricting. These bipartisan groups don't have any incentive to gerrymander. And this is actually how most other Western democracies do it. But all in all, it's still a struggle to determine how to draw lines that are the most fair. And now, we want to hear from you. How does the practice of gerrymandering make you feel about casting a ballot in the future? What else do you want to know about this? Let us know in the comments below. And remember, stay above the noise.